Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create a useful target versus performance chart template in PowerPoint. The template you will learn to create today looks like this. As you can see here, we show the performance here and then we show the target here so that your audience gets a very quick idea of who are the people who have performed above target and who are the ones that have fallen behind. It's a very useful and commonly used chart in a report presentation, and I'm going to show you how to create this chart from scratch. Now, a typical performance versus target chart looks like this. As you can see here, the chart is created fairly simply. The way that we do this is by going to Insert, and then you pick up the chart, and then the default option is here, and then you click on this and you say OK, and a chart like this is presented. And the way to edit this is by right clicking on this, go to Edit Data, and you would be able to see the data that feeds these particular columns. You can see here, this is the performance and this is the target. In this case, we have a standard target across board. Most presenters stop here. They don't really think about how they can make this chart look any better. Now I'm going to show you some simple ways in which you can improve the look and feel of this chart. So first I'm going to select this chart, and then let me go to the Design tab in PowerPoint Ribbon. And the first thing I'm going to do is to see if there are any chart styles that are better than the default option here. The one that I really like is the second one called Style 2. And as you can see here, this is a far more improved version than this typical one. There are a couple of reasons why I feel that this chart, this particular layout is far better. Let me go to the slideshow mode and I'll explain to you why this is better. First, as you can see here, each person's performance is very clearly demarcated using these lines. So visually, your audience won't get confused between the various columns here. The second reason is there is no y-axis here, which means your audience don't have to keep hopping between the y-axis and the columns to figure out what is the value of each of these columns. Of course, there can always be improvements to this where you can see that each of these numbers is written in a different orientation, which makes it difficult for the audience to read. Of course, I would really prefer to have these numbers shown in a proper way so that's much easier for anyone to read these numbers. Otherwise, this is a slightly better version than the one that we had seen earlier. Now I'm going to take this to the next level by selecting this, the second column here. As you can see, this is the target column, and I'm going to go to Change Chart Type. And as you can see here, this is also shown as clustered columns. I'm going to change this to a simple line chart. And now you can see this is far better. And you can see that this line is a visual cue for someone to make sense of the performance. Very quickly, the audience would be able to see the performers who've done better and worse compared to the target. And of course, there are a couple of things that you need to change here. And that is, you can see that there are quite a few data labels here which seem to make this whole thing look a lot messier. So I'm going to select everything and let me go to the plus option here. That opens up this, and here the data labels are shown, and I'm going to uncheck it so that there are no data labels shown. If you want to show the data label for just one of these values, you select this one, just this one. On selecting once, you will have all these data points highlighted. On clicking it again on one specific data point, you would be able to isolate that one. And here you can of course add your data label. And the one thing that I prefer to do is to select everything by clicking on the bounding box, and I'm going to go to home and I'm going to increase the font size so that it's much easier for everyone to read. And now we have this version, which is slightly better. Now that we have got this, let us see if there is any other style that makes this look even better. So I'm going to select this. Let us go to design, and this option is much more beautiful, and I'm going to select this style. And I think this style is called Style 6, so that is beautiful. Now, there is way too much gap between these columns, so I'm going to reduce them. So I'm going to right-click on these columns. Then, let me go to Format Data Series, and that opens up this pane, and I'm going to reduce the gap width So that means we are going to increase the width of these columns. So the more gap width you reduce, that is, the lesser you keep the gap width, the more is going to be the width of these columns. Beautiful. Now let us do the same thing. We are going to select everything and I'm going to increase the font size, and this is much more readable. Now we have got a much more pleasing and more insightful report than the one that we had started out with. And of course, there are a couple of things that we can do to make this even better. And the first thing is we've got this y-axis, though we have the data label. So we are going to select this and I'm going to press delete. And if you want, you can delete this grid lines as well, because we have got the data label. So there is no comparative evaluation here. And this can be brought out so that it's more visible. And you can distinguish this with a different color, maybe yellow color, so that it's much easier to read. And maybe you can increase the size and make it bold so that it's very easy for the audience to see that this is the target and this is the performance. Beautiful, isn't it? Now, I'm going to show you some creative alternatives taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. This bundle is a collection of more than 4,020 premium PowerPoint templates that take your presentation slides to a whole new level. Let me show you the first example. This is called as an equalizer chart. In this case, we are going to present the numbers with this equalizer graphic. As you can see here, this is the target. We have a standard target here. We are going to show performance on a scale of 10, and the individual performances are shown using this beautiful equalizer-like looking columns. Interesting, isn't it? Of course, you can always change your values very easily, like the way that you would do to any chart. You just need to right click, go to edit data, and of course you can populate this with your own data here. You just need to write your performance figures here and the rest is automatically updated. Now I'm going to show you a variation of this, and the variation is this one. As you can see here, the targets are different in each of these cases, and then the performance is shown using this red column. And this is another way in which you can show actual versus budget. And this one is a variation of the earlier chart. As you can see here, we have varying targets shown as an area chart in the background, and then the actual performance is shown using the columns. Now, this one is an advanced version. The beauty of this particular chart is, if the performance is below the target, then you will have these labels shown in a different background. As you can see here, this has a red background with white color text. And now let me show you what happens if this performance increases and this performance decreases. So I'm going to select this chart and I'm going to go to edit data, like the way that I would go to any chart. And you can see here, there are quite a few interesting formulae here. And there is a standard target here, which you can of course change. In this case, let us say instead of 25, I'm going to say 20. So you can see here that the line has already come down. And let us say that in this case, as you can see here, only this month is not performing, and that is what is shown here. And let us say this one, in the month of March, we have 34 as the performance, and let us say the month's performance is only 15, and see what happens here. Instead of 34, I'm going to say 15, and I'm going to press enter, and immediately the color here of the label is shown in a different way. And the same way, when I increase this back to say 25, which is above the target, that is immediately taken care of. It almost works like magic, isn't it? These are some small little things that make a chart look a lot more insightful than the way it is shown typically. Let me show you another example. This one shows performance above and below target using conditional charts. As you can see here, these green dots, as I would call it, are above target and the red ones are below target. Now let us change this. I'm going to select this chart. As you can see here, this is a data-driven chart. I'm going to right click and say edit data. And let us say this particular month, which is month May, the target is below, the performance is below the target of 15. And let us say May's performance is say 9. So instead of 16, I'm going to say 9, which is less than the target here. And let us see what happens. As soon as I change this and hit enter, you can see that the performance is shown differently, and then it has a different look and feel to it. Now, these are some small little improvisations that make your chart attention worthy. Your audience won't just look away as soon as you show this slide in a boardroom. Now they would want to engage with your slide because this chart looks way different from the usual charts that you have seen in a boardroom. Now each of these, though they look like infographic, are totally data driven. And your slides will now command the attention of even the most distracted audience. And that, I think, makes a whole lot of difference in the way you deliver your end result from a presentation. All that and more is available in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. This bundle is a collection of our best-selling PowerPoint templates packs, like our PowerPoint Charts and Diagrams CEO Pack 1, CEO Pack 2, which has graphics and concepts, Advanced Animations Pack, which has more than 750 cutting-edge animations that help you to tell a visual story, Visual PowerPoint Graphs Pack, which has data-driven PowerPoint graph templates like our dual thermometers, bullet charts, speedometers, visual pie charts, dashboards, etc. Flat Design Pack, which has modern flat design style PowerPoint templates. Hand-drawn Graphics Pack, which has slide templates that look very informal like this. Themed title templates that give a good first impression to your audience. And more than 400 new consulting models and frameworks that are not available anywhere else in any of the template sets in the market. If you're someone who's serious about making presentations that influence your career and business, then this is the best PowerPoint bundle you can invest in. And one more thing, as a thank you for watching this video this far, I am happy to offer you our free 5-day email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. Each of the ideas that I share in this practical email course is extremely easy for anyone to pick up and apply in the next presentation. You can sign up for the free email course by clicking on the link here. So please do click, and I will see you inside the email course.